Hello and welcome to my YouTube channel. My name is Alexey, and today what we're gonna be doing is checking out free Studio One controller for iPad. So I got my new iPad here and I decided to check out free Studio One controller for iPad. And let's find out together what you can do by using free Studio One controller on your iPad. So first of all, you can play your audio if you click play button on your iPad. Okay, you can stop your audio playback. Then we can move our faders. We can move our panning. We can mute our audio track. We can solo our audio track. We can also enable input. And if you want to record any instrument, including voice, we can hit this record button and we can start recording. On the left of our iPad, so here, we have some menu and under fader we have inserts. So here we can see all of our plugins. So let's try to open any plugin. Now let's try to open Infinity EQ. So we can open Infinity EQ by clicking here on our iPad. Now let's try to open Virtual Mix Rack. And let's try to open Transient Shaper. Then after inserts we have Sense. And in this session I don't have any sense, so all of my sense are empty. Then we have Q mix, also I don't have anything. And then we have inputs and outputs. So if we want to loop some area in our session, we can use loop on our iPad.
I've been trying to call, I've been on my own for long enough. Maybe you can show me how to love. Maybe I'm going through a drought. You don't even have to do too much.
So now let's take a look here, and here we have some icon which looks like a house. And if we press this icon on our iPad, so we can choose between start and end. So if we press end, it will go to the end of our session. If we hit start, it will go back to the start of our session. So now let's try to create some markers in our session. So by clicking here, you can create markers in your session. If you want to undo or redo any action in your template, so here we have undo arrow, so we can undo any action in our template. And next to undo arrow, we have redo arrow. Now let's click here. So by clicking here, we are opening a menu of our macros. So here we have a menu for our macros, and you can see what kind of macros you can use in each menu. So for instance, let's open view menu, and here we have some macros. For instance, if we click on console, we can open a console in our DAW. Then by clicking on editor, we can open audio editor. Then we have zoom in. Then we have zoom out. Then we have zoom in vertical. Then we have zoom out vertical. Then we have browser. Then we have show instruments. Then we have show effects. Then we have show pool. Then behind this watermark we have zoom full, and we have a bunch of other great macros. Now let's open console menu. So here we can choose from add, insert, add, send, open channel. So in this case, it opens our vocal channel. Then here we have add effects channel. So it creates a new effects channel. Then we have show channel editor. Now let's open audio menu, and here we have a lot of great macros we can choose from. So for instance, we can reverse any audio. So right now let's try to reverse our vocals, and right now we have our vocals reversed. Then we can increase volume of our audio track, or we can decrease volume of our audio track. Now let's try edit with Melodyne. Then we have remove Melodyne, so right now let's remove it. And after removing Melodyne, we don't have Melodyne on our vocal audio track anymore. So now let's open automation, and here we have some macros for writing down and working with automation. So for instance, we have three modes of automation. So we can read our automation. So now, as you can see on our vocal audio file, we have read mode for our automation. Then we can write our automation, and now we're in write mode. Then we have touch mode of our automation, and right now we are, and right now we are in touch mode. Then we can turn off our automation. Then we can show envelopes of our automation. So here and here it shows envelopes of automation. And right now let's try macros menu. So here we have a lot of macros we can choose from. We can apply reverse reverb to any audio file. We can copy any audio file to a new layer. We can create sound macros. Then we can increase volume of any audio track to plus 3 dB. And also we have zoom overview. And finally we have music creation or music creating menu. And here we have some macros for music creation, for music composing when you are using virtual instruments and when you are using MIDI data. So that's how you can use FreeStudio One controller on your iPad, which will help you to speed up your workflow. Thank you so much for watching, and see you next time.